Our top story this morning, that wild weather from coast to coast. Thunderstorm asthma warnings upgraded in Melbourne. Another smoky day in Sydney. And severe fire danger warnings for Adelaide. We've got it all covered this morning. We'll go first to today, Melbourne reporter Isabella Stashkovsky and that asthma alert there. Isabella, why have authorities now upgraded the warning?
Well, Tom, I've just spoken to a forecaster from the Bureau of Meteorology who's explained the situation a little further. And basically, Melbourne is going to get hot and it's going to get windy. Now, the reason for that is hot air coming from New South Wales and Queensland. And right now, there's a lot of people out and about enjoying what is truly a beautiful morning, but it is certainly going to change, reaching about 34 degrees. Now, that has prompted an asthma thunderstorm warning from authorities as well. And we know that in 2016, Melbourne faced the world's biggest event of that kind. Thousands of people had problems with breathing, and in fact, 9 people lost their lives. So it is very serious. It's certainly a day to look out for your mates. But there is a cool change expected this evening around midnight, with that forecaster saying there could be more thunderstorms. And Tom, in fact, this evening that will spur more changes. And this weekend, it could be tropical conditions in Melbourne, despite it being in the low 20s.
All right, Isabella, thank you. We'll head to Sydney now. Our reporter Lara Vella is tracking the thick smoke that's really been choking the city for days now. Lara, how much longer till it starts to clear?
Tom, according to the Bureau, this smoke haze will linger in Sydney until around Sunday. And you can see by the view this morning just behind me that there is indeed still that murky haze choking our suburbs. And in fact, this morning, Sydney is falling within the top 10 most polluted major centres in the world. Our air quality levels today, again, lingering between poor to hazardous. So the warning from health authorities for anyone with serious breathing difficulties is the best bet for them today is to try and stay indoors and keep that air conditioning on where it's nice and cool. Now, the Bureau says the reason that we're seeing this smoke hang around is because of those northeasterly breezes. They start up around Byron Bay and then they hover around Port Macquarie, where, of course, we've had those bushfires burning for some time now. And by the time it reaches Sydney, well, of course, it's brought all that fresh smoke with it. So we are expecting by around late Sunday afternoon that we will see a change in the wind direction, and as a result, this smoke will finally dissipate.
All right, Lara, thank you. I want to bring in Rhys D'Alessandro now in Adelaide. He's got the latest on the fire bans there. Rhys, authorities really on high alert.
Yeah, they certainly are this morning, Tom. Warm temperatures overnight have prompted the CFS to issue total fire bans across 5 districts right across the state. The bushfire risk is severe, and any residents living in those bushfire-prone areas are being urged to enact their bushfire survival plans. It's going to be a top of 32 degrees in Adelaide today. The sun just coming up behind us here this morning. It is quite hazy already, and just in the last half hour or so, the wind is starting to pick up as well too. Wind gusts of up to 50 kilometres an hour today. Northern first, and then a strong and volatile change for a southwesterly change coming in later this afternoon before a cool change into the evening. So a real roller coaster ahead for South Australians, Tom.
All right, Therese, Lara and Isabella, thank you. And also look in Perth, it's being hit by wild weather as well. Strong winds, rain and hail hitting the city. More than 7,000 properties lost power as a result of that. A real surprise icy spring burst. Trees ended up being brought down, one crushing a car when winds struck at 90k an hour.
Looked out the window, big gusts of wind, and all of a sudden there were sparks and stuff flying down, got greeted with this nice little gift.
It looks like a disaster zone.
A severe weather warning is now in place for WA's southwest with up to 100 km an hour winds forecast there.